Operation report. Detections, repairs complete. Contact report. Contact report, detections. Contact report, kill credit. Contact report. Contact report, recon, Osaka. Oh, a crash. Written off. The 503rd Parachute Regiment is moved, and the 171st Wing is also moved. Repairs complete. Expansions. Repairs complete. Upgrade. Reinforcements. Los Angeles, Alameda, San Francisco. These are the aircraft transferred to San Francisco. No submarines in Hong Kong. Two submarines in Shanghai. Tunny is in for repairs. Refuel and repair. Yeah, one day she's out. The Sturgeon is going back on to patrol in Shikoku Station. No aircraft are scheduled to transfer out through either Hong Kong or Shanghai. No enemy air action on the southeast coast of Japan. Nothing here. Are there? No. Normally I do a little summary at the end of the month, but I think we better do one here now. Let me explain you what happened. Let me explain you. There was the armored unit here. We were trying to get the enemy. Well, not trying to get the enemy. I was moving into Maybashi, and I was sending a column of 9,000 assault value into here because there was only one unit at the other end. I intended to smash that one unit, just obliterate it, before moving on up to Nagaoka. Now, what happened was, I sent the column, and one of the units, this one, United States, this one, United States Amphibious Tank Battalion, somehow managed to get there 2 days early. Because it got there 2 days early, that one, it gave the AI a chance to start pushing units out from Tokyo. Tokyo's got 251 still, and right now there's 37 up here. So this was all, there was one. 36 units just came up the road from Tokyo. So for 2 days, he had a 2 day advance, and finally, last turn, there were 17 here. He just shoved another 20 into the hex. And probably, I don't know how many more are coming. So the plan originally was match 9,000 assault value against one little base force, blast it. Had this worked, had this idiot not gone through and gone in 2 days early and warned the enemy, because I knew this was going to happen. Once you trigger it, the AI reacts when you're one hex away from one of these major bases here, or Kobe or Osaka. The AI will come out when you're one hex away. So by triggering it early, the AI had 2 days to start moving stuff up, and he got 17, and then he got 20 more up here while my column tried to move in. The column did move in, 9,400 assault value or so, but it's too late. I thought I was attacking 17 yesterday. It turns out that he dropped the other 20 in there. That's 37. So had I blasted 9,000 assault value against one base force, obliterated it, then the next group coming up was 17, I might have beaten it. 9,000 against 17, could have beaten it. Could have. I think I might have. Maybe not. And then but 9,000 against 37? No, not a snowball's hope in hell. The terrain is mountainous, so that means it's a 3x modifier. So it's 1-2 odds, meaning that since we had about 9,400, let's call it 10,000 on here. If we had 10,000 assault value and it's 1-2 odds, the enemy had an adjusted value of 20,000. Let's say 20,000. So one, and that was after tripling. So I would say this 3,700 would have approximately 6,600, maybe 7,000 assault value. All because one tank battalion blew it. Stupid. Just beyond stupid. Okay, so the AI has done something good. He's countered my pair. There's no way I'm going to blast through this. Options. I still have 9,100. We're badly bruised. We lost quite a number of units. Good. I'm glad this guy took the heaviest loss. 31%. Good job. Hope the commander was killed. Imbecile. Where is it? Where is the commander? Ah, here. And he's supposedly one of the top land commanders with a rating of 73. Aggression of 78. Who knows how he got up there. Okay, so he's very disrupted right now. We're no longer in attack mode. So what are my options right now? The fatigue is incredible on this guy. Disruption's huge, 51%. So we're not doing any attacking anytime soon. I think the advance is pretty much stalled. I have 9,100 here. We went in from the west. So we don't even have a rail line. See, we're not even connected by supply by railway. So I've ordered one of my units here, one of the minor engineers, one of these little fragments, to start moving to the southeast. Let's try to open up a path for supplies to flow into the hex at least. I can't go forward. I can't defeat this. Plus whatever else is coming up, I can't defeat this. The options I think I have are we have the rest of the column of 13,000. I could bring the 13,000 in here, and if we grind long enough, I think we'd win. But the enemy situation is he has a virtual, 3-4 million supply points in Tokyo to send up here, and he can send up another 251 units if he wants, up to that much. It's virtually unlimited. It may as well be unlimited. So we're not getting in this way. What to do? So do I commit the rest? This 13,000 is still bigger than anything out here. Bigger than the column that's already in here. But that's it. There's nothing else coming. You take a look at the reinforcements. Well, just take a look at the infantry. Oh, infantry and armor are the two big ones. In 16 days, we have a one regiment. And then the next one doesn't come. Oh, this is Soviet. It doesn't even count. We can't even use it. Next one's a little tank battalion. 69 days to get to even enter the game. And then we have to get them to Japan. This is it. There's nobody else coming. We have a couple of infantry divisions here. Oops. To be generous, we would call this 1,000. That'd be generous. Some of that, yeah, that's some of that's chindit that doesn't, well, I don't really count the chindits as regular formation. Let's say it's 1,000. We've got 1,000 up here, 2,300 up here, and 17, that's 4,000. Let's call that 4,000. So that's not a hell of a lot. There's nothing else coming. We have to get ourselves out of this situation somehow, or try to. I don't want to wait 3 years until the Soviets activate, but that I might have to. There's just not enough killing power. Just troop for troop, I don't know if there's enough killing power. Okay, so what am I going to do with these guys? All right, so I've got 13,000 in my mobile column here. These are not as mobile as the tanks. We don't have any arm. We don't have much armor here. Yeah, no armor. I got a couple of tank battalions here, tank destroyer, and a squadron. That tank destroyer. Virtually nothing. So my mobile. This is my mobile column. The only mobile column I have. uncommitted. What I could do is I could try to work my way around Nagaoka. It only has seemed to have one unit here. We could try to work around here, block, smash this unit, and continue around to encircle. Could try that. But I've got three hotbeds, three big bases back here that haven't been sealed, properly sealed yet. At four, Yokohama. Also, it's October 24th, so within two months, there's going to be bloody kamikazes in the damn area. So, what to do? Continue to the east, or try to snuff out these hotbeds. This 12,000 should be able to destroy each and every one of these nests, because they're all isolated. All the low on supply, they're all isolated. We should be able to crush them, but we won't be able to go to relieve Maebashi. So I think this is what I'm going to do. Start building fortifications here. We may need to fight on this one. I'm going to try to open up this hex side so we can retreat back through this way. If not, we can still try to retreat into the mountains here and then back up. But we ain't getting any further here. This column, I'm going to order, it's a little risky, I think. I'm going to order them to clear out these bastards here, wipe them out. And to hell with the points. If we don't, I'm not leaving garrisons, just soak up the point, just give the enemy victory points every turn. I'm not going to waste, I don't have enough. I just don't have enough. So what we're going to do is we're going to come down, I'm going to order them come down this hex, and then I'm going to go into Kofu. There's only one unit here. With 12,000, I think we can blast the hell out of it the way that we were supposed to do on Maebashi. Blast it. And the AI will try to respond. The AI will send units down, try to clear, to support Kofu. By the time they get there, I'm hoping to move down to Shimizu to clear it, and then clear up into Nagoya. Here are the roads. There's no real, see, that's where the rail is, the rail links are, and here are the road links. So I'm going to try to clear this one, go down here. There's 10 units here. If I can blast this one clean, move over here, blast this one clean. Now if I leave the hex from Kofu out, the enemy may very well recapture it. Will likely recapture it. And he could cut me off behind enemy lines with no field of supply, no route, supply route. Because this is the way I'm coming in. This is my supply route along this railway. To combat that, I've got units here. I'm going to have two units here. I'm going to have one unit here try to move to the southeast to open up this hex side, and another unit time it to move to the southwest to open up the other hex side. So even if the AI seals the deal behind me, seals the door behind me, I can still get some supply through this hex side from the railroad. The rail will run down to here and then through the hex. It's not as good, but it should give me enough until I can destroy Nagoya. So by taking this hex, I'll move over to Hamamatsu, take this hex, I'll just herd them into Nagoya, kill the vermin, move up, kill the vermin, and over to finish off Kobe. Then we come back down and clean out Yokohama. Yokohama is probably the only base I absolutely have to have in Japan in order to go after Tokyo. So that's, these guys are good, just going to fight. I suspect the AI is going to bring up his artillery and just try to bombard me to death. Harass the hell out of me, bombard me to death. So eventually I am going to have to pull out of here. Sooner or later. But if I'm holding the enemy's attention here, maybe I can free up the column of 12 to go down through here, wipe out these guys. It's going to take most of October, the rest of October, most of November to do this. I'll be lucky if I can finish it by the end of November, and then head back here. I want to clean out these so that we don't have any chance of kamikazes. If I keep bringing the supplies in from Iwo Jima across to Nagasaki, supplies flow on the rail, they'll go directly. So I don't need to worry about kamikazes if I can try coming in the backside. Yes, there are kamikazes operating out of Okinawa and Tohoku, but not nearly as many as are probably going to be found at Tokyo. Okay? Everyone clear on that plan? What a crusterfuck! Oh, it's a little bit of a gamble. He could seal me in behind here without cut off from supplies. Could. And then who's going to rescue the armor? So this is kind of a bass backwards. Instead of bashing away with the infantry, my armor's caught up, spearhead's caught up here. Let me see. If we took out, see, here's all the armor. If I took out there's still lots of infantry. See, the infantry moves more slowly than the armor. So if I try to move out of here, the armor might very well be leave the infantry behind. Because otherwise I have got to go into every mother-loving, god-awful unit and click it and control it this way. Once, I'll move, then I'll stop, then I'll move, then I'll stop, then to keep it from moving faster than the infantry. Oh, for the love of God. All right, so, okay. So that's the situation, that's my plan. Let's punch out these nests of vermin and then come back to rescue the armor, or else, or probably, I'll just take Yokohama and then I can start running battleships straight into Tokyo. I won't be able to seal it off, but it's not like Tokyo is getting a lot of supplies from the other bases up here. Tokyo is usually sending it out if it has to. It's where it flows into Tokyo. These bases don't make, well, they do make some, but not as much. I will try. We don't know what else is down here. I'm trying to march around it to seal it off. But if I need to, I might have to do an amphibious landing. I really don't want to do that. Amphibious landings are very, very dicey affairs. Even against the AI, you never know what you're going to get. So marching across is the safer bet if I can do that. If I have to relieve the armor, we'll back it out of here and then just go straight up along Nagaoka and around to try to seal up the rest of it. Okay, let's get to it. Sure, so we've purchased the division, loading it along with a bunch of base forces. They're all down, pretty much all down now. At Nagasaki, we have two, when things go wrong, things usually go wrong for lots of people. Two transport squadrons have managed to make it all the way to Nagasaki. The ammunition ships got in here and dropped into port right away. These other transports are starting to unload. The other ones didn't make it here. For some reason, I mean, we've been doing it for a while now, and they always made it. But this is the first time I've ordered each task force to break apart, pretty much break apart and proceed on their own to try to get in. And this is the time that didn't work. Every other time it just, well, they all arrived at the same, they all arrived within 3 days at Nagasaki. Just goes to some, I don't know how they're plotting. It should be easier to plot this way rather than trying to follow someone, in my opinion. Oh well, we've got coverage. The transports will arrive next turn and unload. Okay, so I'm starting to put the plan into motion. We've got the units redirecting. We're still going to conduct airstrikes on Osaka. If it's got supplies now, well, the less supplies it has, the easier it will be to kill. Still a couple of straggling base force. We have the provisional tank brigade. We might just need the damn thing. Oh boy. Oh, get on the rail. Set all to march. Anybody else coming up? No. Oh, here we are at Liu Chao. Okay. Over to Changsha. Nothing at Langson. Nothing at Bianhua. Two more units coming across, but it's just headquarters and anti-aircraft artillery. Bangkok is clear. Victoria Point repaired another 2%. Quiet in Singapore. No additional unit arrived at Moulmein. No additional unit at the commando brigade is still collecting at Rangoon. Transports are back, okay. Transports are back, we'll dock. Load troops are the commandos. Is that it? The commandos. Okay, let's go to Rangoon. If the commandos are being loaded, let's turn off the transports. They don't need to fly them. We'll just change to training. Here we are. Oh boy. How's the Akyab army? No, still sitting at 15 disruptions. 15 level disruption. Too much. Too much. Have to wait a few more days. We're quiet on Colombo. Carrier moving past Bombay. Bombay's silent. Karachi, we have two supply convoys. This is an AKV. It's much faster than the other, so I've left it separate on the return trip. Abadan, convoy finishing loading fuel. Aden, we have some transports returned with LSTs. I'm ordering those transports to join up with this slow poker, all speed 11. Two more transports. Okay. And another group of transports. I should probably just group those two together. There we go. Speed 12. These guys are finishing. The other guys are going to go. Then we'll take off together. No additional reinforcements at Aden. No reinforcements in South Africa. Checking on submarine. No damaged submarines. Low fuel. K-8 returning and K-11 already inbound. Runner and Pargo received their withdrawal notices or return notices. Tullaby. Where are you, Tullaby? Here you go. Call them back. And Kingfish as well. Okay, well, where's the icon? Oh, for goodness sake, okay. Is this another bug? Who knows? Gotta be. Where is it down here? Torpedo check. 019 and 20 successfully engaged barges. But still have ammo, so they're staying on station. Two enemy submarines near Rabaul, or not near Rabaul, but Great Britain. Penape, the landing ship dock, returned, refueled, and didn't do anything. Okay, now we're going to tell them to sit here, load supply, fill up, and then I'll tell them to leave for... Let's see if we can't do it any better. Once you're full, go. Well, let's see if they fill up this time, right? They should be able to fill up. I can understand how competing with three or four different groups and maybe there's an error. Yeah, one or two, I can understand, might happen. Okay, shouldn't, but it might. So they're all alone. They should be able to go by themselves. Two LSTs have arrived. We may as well unload and disband these guys. They have a little bit of damage, but we can repair that next turn. Another LST inbound. Quiet in Panama. Pearl Harbor. We have a transport. Okay, what is it? This is one of those collision boys. Okay, anyone to take? We could take. Is there anything to take? Could take one of the anti-aircraft, but he's gone in 38 days. What's the point? Okay, instead, we're just going to load up with supplies and head over to Iwo. Catalina, we're resting in order to replace another inbound. Who are these? Submarine tender and subchaser, minesweeper. Two transports have arrived, one Alameda heading for San Francisco and another one at Los Angeles. Los Angeles, we have the two tankers were repaired, sending them off, loading them and sending them off. I'm sending the reinforcement transport off with supplies as well. At San Francisco, a number of the Speedy 17s have returned. They're dropping into they have resupplied, and I've dropped them. They've reloaded with supplies. A couple other are still loading. We'll finish them off before dropping them in for storage. A transport group has arrived, partially damaged. One of them was not damaged, and I'm going to send her out. She's loading one of the Thunderbolt squadrons. Several have just arrived. Here's you go. Three Thunderbolt squadrons. I've loaded one already. Three Thunderbolt, an Era Cobra, and a couple of Recon squadrons. The Recon we don't need as badly right now. We're covering that sufficiently. But the fighters, the Thunderbolts, they could really help quickly. So loading them next turn when the transports are repaired, we'll load the other fighter squadrons. Two more Thunderbolt and a Era Cobra. One tanker is loading from San Francisco and another one is loading, two more, from Los Angeles. Both headed for Iwo Jima. Iwo Jima, several transports have arrived. They're low on fuel and I want to refuel them, but I'm not going to do so until I'm waiting for the tankers to arrive. I don't want to take away from my ready supply. Here are some tankers already. They're here. If in a pinch, I could use these guys, but I don't want to use them because these are scheduled. They're scheduled for Japan. In the base, we also have some AOEs. Ooh, what are these guys doing here? The little ones, the slow ones, the 11s and 13s aren't going to Japan because they're slow. I'm keeping them out here. I'm going to keep to facilitate in case when the convoys come back, they need a lot of fuel really quickly, and the base usually doesn't have enough, isn't able to give it to them. So having AOs like this, refueling the whole convoy at the same time, makes it much more, they can turn around much more quickly. And then now when the convoy is gone, they can slowly refuel themselves from Iwo Jima. So I've got the big transports and the AOs sitting in a task force here because I don't want the new inbound groups to show up and suck the fuel out of them. It's okay to suck it out of Iwo Jima, but not on the ones heading for Japan. So these guys are coming in. They need to come in. They don't have a full load of supply, so I'm going to... Oh, these idiots. Criminy. There's a reason why they don't have a full load. I set them up for amphibious, so they only load 80%. God, I'm stupid. Oh, jeez. Okay, I'll order them to disband into the base, and then they can reload a full amount. Here's another one coming in. No. It's full. Yep. Turn off the refuel. We only need, well, this guy's got 9,900. He's got plenty. There's a couple of low ones, but we'll do it manually so that we make sure we suck it from the tankers and not from the base. Here's another one. Again, setting it for amphibious. Oh, gosh. How sloppy can you get, eh? How sloppy? I gave it an amphibious designation so that I could distinguish it from the other groups, but I forgot to switch it back when we loaded. So I'm an idiot. That's why it loads 80% and they didn't get a full load. I'm not too bright, am I? Alright, units have dropped into Iwo Jima. We'll try to repair as many as we can. Ooh, the Jason. Ah, a new repair vessel. Right. I reckon the more repair vessels I can bring to the area, the more ships they can help. But the repair vessels will not conduct repairs until they themselves are repaired. Isn't that odd? Well, not quite odd. That's reasonable, isn't it? The cruiser squadron has returned and reloaded, rearmed. Okay, we now... Oh, right, there's some squadrons waiting to withdraw. Dauntless, 2 days out of Fusan. Okay, this one's coming back, but that's all right. We'll make sure we get all the pilots out first. We're going to withdraw the group. Do we take the points or take the planes? These are old SBD ones. Let's take the points. Ogden. Okay, we have Luganville. We have PBY-5 Catalinas. We have a squadron here, PBY-5 Catalinas. Oh, these guys are already searching up here. Where's the other one? Here's the five alphas. These guys are leaving from Rabaul in 12 days. So these guys are ready. PBY 5 alphas. Let's see if we can't get down to Rabaul. Easiest is to search by name. No. Nothing's ever easy in this freaking game. Okay, let's go to Guam and then transship down to... There we go. We'll rest at Guam and we'll go to Rabaul next turn. K-16 engages a landing barge with guns. 11 hits. Might be enough to sink it. O-24 does not fire. O-16 does not fire. That's one lucky landing barge. Air attack, Nagano. 17 aircraft in. We have 51 aircraft defending. Seven are shot down. Bombing practice, Akyab. Airstrike on Osaka. 23 zeros interfere. Whoa, I put three squadrons on defense? Wow. I thought I only put two. Okay, we shoot down 11 of them. But we also lose... Holy cow, that's a terrible score. What is... they're not that good. We lose four top-line fighters. And a Dauntless dive bomber to flak. More bombing practice, Akyab. I gotta check that. I thought I only assigned two squadrons for combat air patrol. Oh, I missed it. Another attack, and 1-0 was defending. Oh, come on. Where the hell are the rest of the attackers? That's twice. Do I really have to set the attack every damn turn to get the airstrikes from Fusan? This is starting to get ridiculous. Come on. Kobe. Japanese bombardment. Well, they still have ammo. But we destroy one of their squads. Here's a big attack at Maybashi. He's trying to throw me out of the hex. The terrain modifier works both ways. If he attacks me, I get the benefit of triple defense modifier. Well, that was pretty suspenseful. Useless, but suspenseful. Bombardment, 70... Well, no allied casualties, but we did destroy one of the enemy squads. Oh, boy. Must have been a lot of calculations. Ground combat, bombardment, Osaka. No allied casualties. Negligible Japanese casualties. Allied bombardment at Kobe. Well, we got one squad. Big, hairy deal. Bombardment, Osaka. Bombardment, Allied bombardment, Osaka. Again, negligible. Two lousy squads disabled. Was it even worth the ammo? Su expands. Gifu expands, maximizes. Nagano expands fortifications, so otherwise known as shallow.